Washington funds Ukraine forever war while our own soldiers' barracks rot. This is disgusting. We have an America last president that's not even supporting any of our best interests. I mean, we pay our taxes in hopes that these people in government serve our best interests, not the interests of other countries. But it seems like every single individual in government has other people interests, place other people interests ahead of our own. It's disgusting to look at what's going on in our country and know that we're sending hundreds of billions of dollars to other countries that really don't care anything about us and don't have our best interests at heart. We are literally funding Nazis right now in the Ukraine. I've done a whole video on that. And it's disgusting what they're doing to our own soldiers. But before we get started, go ahead and hit that like button. Share this out so we can get this information out there. Subscribe if you're not already a subscriber. Hit that alarm bell so you know when I'm putting out new stuff. Also, check out my link tree in the description. It has a link to my Patreon where I talk about things I can't talk about here. There's also a link to my Instagram and my merch store. Also, check out jjthepsychotherapist.com for news as well. All right, let's talk about this news. House Speaker Kevin McCarthy reversed his earlier stance on removing U.S. aid to Ukraine from the House Republicans' defense spending bill, stating that the funds would indeed be included in the legislation. So even people on the right are still supporting this bullcrap. Initially, McCarthy had announced that U.S. aid for Ukraine would be excluded from the House Republicans' defense appropriations bill and would be subject to a separate vote in the lower chamber. He had said, quote, it would be out and voted on by itself. This decision to include $300 million for Ukraine's ongoing conflict with Russia was reported by Just the News. However, when questioned about the matter on Saturday, McCarthy changed his position, citing the difficulty of removing the Ukraine funding and decided to leave it in the bill. So it was too hard. It was too hard to take out. So he just gave up on it, basically. I mean, McCarthy is a rhino. It seems like whenever people get in position of power like this, I think they got dirt on these people. So they have to do the deep state bidding. McCarthy is no different. But this reversal by the House Speaker came shortly after President Joe Biden's announcement of an additional $325 million in U.S. military aid to Ukraine, including air defense capabilities, cluster munitions, and anti-tank weapons. Ukrainian President Vladimir Zelensky had visited Washington, D.C. with the intention of securing funding from Western nations for his country's conflict with Russia. While the Biden administration and Congress have been actively supporting Ukraine's military, concerns have risen about the well-being of American service men and women. 2 days before Biden's meeting with Zelensky, the Government Accountability Office, or GAO, released a report detailing substandard living conditions in barracks at various U.S. military installations. According to military.com, The report extensively documented, quote, substandard conditions, including issues like bed bugs and roaches, which were prevalent at six of the bases inspected by the GAO. Water quality problems were also noted, with some service members reporting unsafe drinking water due to brown discoloration. Look at how we're treating our military, the people we're asking to defend us. Additional issues identified at the inspected installations including broken windows, malfunctioning air conditioning units, lax security measures, insufficient waste disposal, and mold growth. And we send in billions of dollars to Ukraine. This makes no sense. So let's get this straight. The GAO placed responsibility for the problems squarely on the Department of Defense and highlighted the agency's ineffective oversight of barracks conditions. The report summary stated, quote, DOD does not track information on the condition of barracks or facilitate collaboration on initiatives to improve barracks. Insufficient oversight hampers DOD ability to identify and address longstanding challenges in barracks conditions across the department. So they're not taking any accountability for it. I mean, this is your government here. This is what we do to people that's charged with defending us. Again, but they have no problem sending hundreds of billions of dollars to a Nazi infiltrated country. But furthermore, the GAO pointed out that the Pentagon's lack of attention to this issue obstructs its ability to obtain accurate funding information for maintaining habitable barracks, despite requesting approximately $15 billion from Congress for, quote, overall facility sustainment. In 2024 fiscal year, the DOD could not specify how much of that funding would go towards barracks. I mean, military.com analysis of the GAO report noted that Pentagon leaders not only failed to provide adequate oversight, but also do not consider the issue a priority, leading to bureaucratic finger pointing and lack of ownership of the problem. But they got no problem teaching this DEI crap that has nothing to do with the military and defending our country. They have no problem teaching all this woke stuff. But according to the report, substandard living conditions in U.S. military barracks are estimated to affect at least thousands of service members across the country. Again, this is how they treat service members. They don't care anything about people defending this country. What do you think they care about you? Nothing. They don't care anything about you. They take our tax dollars and send it to other countries. And then they borrow trillions of dollars and send that over to other countries. It's disgusting. But let me know what you think. Leave your comments down below. Like, share, and subscribe. And check out JJThePsychotherapist.com for the latest in news. Until next time, peace.